I'm going to start with Samsara's mission. They are on a mission to improve the safety, efficiency, and sustainability of physical operations that power really hard parts of our economy. Sanjeet and John are previous co-founders of Meraki. They had a $1.2 billion exit with Cisco, and I have a feeling that they are building a company that they will never sell. Their team and culture is highly differentiated. They believe in partnering with customers and building on long-term solutions that are durable. And that will be great for the company. They are primarily collaborative and entrepreneurial, so they are very innovative in the solution. This has been their trajectory. I would just focus on the last part where they have surpassed 10,000 customers. It's actually 13,000 customers that are their core customers, where they get more than $5,000 of ARR from them. In terms of the platform itself, they have sensors across all the hardware that you see in physical operations. All that data from the sensors goes to their IoT platform. There is a data platform in their connected operations cloud, which does all the things like ingestion, aggregation, and enrichment with other third-party sources. On top of this data platform, they have built a bunch of applications that are highly complementary to their physical operation. These are some of the applications they have. Too much to talk here. I have a blog post on this that will be more valuable. In terms of customer value proposition, their main goal is customers are able to see their entire physical operations in a single pane of glass, kind of similar to Palantir. They improve safety and reduce cost, and they are putting efforts in increasing the operational efficiency of their customers and enhancing the sustainability. In terms of their primary moat, it's a really sticky software platform, which is reinforced by their hardware devices that can't be taken out once you integrate them. They have modularized their platform further to allow people to develop integrations on them. Other than that, most of their customers are already using two or more applications. They have a high dollar-based net retention rate for their bigger customers of 125%. That adds to the switching cost. Financials, I'm not going to go over them a lot. You can see the LTV CAC there, that's 8x, so profitable unit economics. Other than that, they have constantly expanded gross margins over the past 2.5 years, reduced their operating expenses, and they have grown ARR at a crazy rate. Last but not the least, if you look at their customers, core customers with more than 100K ARR, they have grown them 7.7 times in 2.5 years. This is an incredible compounding rate that you won't see in any other enterprise software company.
Really big fan of the business, but similar to what was going on with SpeedGreen, in being simple as salads, I understand it's a tech company and like they are losing a lot of money, you know, year over year. So I'm curious to know, like, at what point has management really said that they're going to be putting an emphasis on, you know, making sure their bottom line is an actual like reality? And then if so, like what kind of time frame does that look like on when that could be achievable in the future?
Talking about profitability, if you look at the unit economics, the business is profitable on a unit basis. The only concern that you should have with this business is it burning too much money. If you look at the operating expenses for the IPO, they are burning 100% of their money or the revenue, what they are getting from the business to invest for growth. If you look at the market opportunity, it's 55 billion. And actually, the farther out in the future they get profitable, it's going to be better for me. I want them to lose money for next 5 years to grab the market opportunity. That's how I'm looking at it. From the management perspective, I'm not sure of what kind of guidance they have for profitability, but I'm sure with the platform they are building and the differentiated culture and the mission they have, it won't be in the near future for at least 3 years. In terms of like long-term profit margins or EBITDA margins that you want to look for, my management has said that it's going to be around 20%, and that's it.
I understand the whole growth story, but if it's like a minimum of like 3 years, do they have the ability to make that without necessarily further dilution, right? Like, can they do it with the cash they have on the balance sheet? You know, like trying to be like flat free cash flow positive. Like, how are they trying to get there without making sure that their investors are, you know, getting hurt in the interim?
In terms of stock dilution, I don't know if you're familiar with the economics of SaaS-based companies. Usually, people follow adjusted multiples and adjusted gross margins and everything adjusted. In that, the SBC is usually when you're running the business, they consider that as borrowing money from the future. You're borrowing money from the future in terms of stock compensation, and the stock takes care of itself. I have calculated their dilution. It's not more than 4% at the IPO. And I think that's a reasonable number to keep at. So in terms of SBC, that will be their goal for actually getting the operating leverage. So here you can already see that they have been focusing on reducing their operating expenses. The main point to look at over here is the spending is at 100% on IPO. What this means is that the business is at a certain economies of scale where they can just put their entire revenue, reinvest in the business and grow profitably. So their sales efficiency is around 1.3, which gives us the indication that if they invest a dollar in the business, they are getting $1.30 from the business. So I don't see how they won't get profitable. Because if you see at this, look at this graph, they have reduced their operating expenses by 3x from 287 to 100%. So I think the story stays. They will keep executing on it. I know it's a little bit concerning, you know, that you can't see it, but you'll see it in the future.
So I was wondering about the cash flow statement. They are still very cash flow negative and have been diluting their share count to make up for it. When do you see that reversing, at least slowing down?
Not for the next 3 years after that, probably. That's how people invest in growth businesses. If it was up to me, I would like to see them not be profitable for the next 5 years and grab the entire market share and be a big monopoly. But that's just me.